Hello, everyone, and welcome to Gray Mane Gaming. My name is Gray, and we are playing a little bit of Zelda. Actually, you know what? We're not going to play Zelda today. We are going to play Zelda in a minute or two, or 10 or 20. But I'm going to do what I used to do on my videos, and we're going to read comments from our viewers. So this video will be exclusively a platform, or, you know, this game, this iteration of Zelda. Well, no, I won't be playing any Zelda on it. I'm going to be reading comments, and then in the next video, I'll be doing the gameplay. Okay? So I just want you, if you came here to watch me play through Zelda, this won't be happening in this video. This is only for comments and reading viewers' comments and me responding. I like to respond on video because it's a lot better, because people can get text misconstrued. So I'd rather try to respond if I can through voice. So we're going to do that. We're going to read some comments and respond and talk about things for a few minutes, and then we will in the next video we'll continue the Zelda gameplay. I'm just using this as a platform to talk through. I wish I could turn the music all the way up, but I can't. Nintendo, you need to get your hardware together, man. You need to get your hardware together. Seriously. All right. We got our first comment from Ian Gator. Ian, where have you been? I haven't heard from you in such a long time. So good to hear from you, though. Ian Gator says, "Hey, Gray, been thinking about buying Astrobot." Don't even think about it, Ian. Don't even think about it. Buy it. This is what we call a system seller. People are going out and buying PS5s, and I think one of them is Cookie Coco, from what I remember, for Astrobot. It's a system seller. It is. It's got rave reviews. Everyone says it's the game. It's like the one of the best platformers of all time, and I agree with them. If you like nostalgia, if you like old PlayStation games, if you like Castlevania, if you like Crash Bandicoot, anything like that, this is your game. All right, it kind of harkens back to old platformers. It's like they're calling it the Mario of PlayStation. So please, if you like that kind of game, do not hesitate. Go out today and pick it up. All right, do it. I guarantee you won't be disappointed. So yeah, pick it up. So Ian Gator says, been thinking about buying Astrobot. We covered that. I can assume, since you are playing it on your channel, it's a fun game. Don't assume that, because I played a lot of games that aren't fun. And I don't play them anymore. So that, yeah. So, yeah. And yes, the game devs always hide something. Yeah, you know what? I was looking back on, what are you thinking of, Gray? No, it's not junk in your trunk. Oh, no. Trunk of Funk. That's what it is. The Astrobot video I did earlier tonight. There I was watching next. I have to kind of rewatch it and just make sure everything's kosher. And I was looking at it, and there's these great big suns that are there. I think you can touch those. I'm not sure, but it sure looks like you can. And I kind of kicked myself for not. I mean, I ran right past them, and I fought right in front of them, and I didn't even touch them. So I'm gonna have to go back and have a look at them, I think. On the Trunk of Funk. I don't know why I said junk in your trunk. This is a family channel, Gray. Family. So yeah, that is a game to buy. That is a game to own, for sure. Ian Gator says, enjoy the rest of your week, buddy. Oh, thank you so much, Ian. I'm so glad that you're back, and glad to see you. Hope you're doing well. And yes, you have my my opinion on, of course it's my opinion, but if you go and read the reviews, platformer, one of the greatest platformers, if not the greatest platformer, for the PlayStation, and maybe a contender for a top platformer. So really, really fun game. You can't go wrong. I mean, I'm sure you've spent a lot of, like, I mean, I spent like, for like what was it, a couple weeks ago, like $60 on Funko Fusion. Ugh, there's a game that I stopped playing, and I paid $70 for it. Oh, I don't want to do this. And I paid $70 for it, and I haven't touched it. Haven't touched it. It's just not a fun game. So, yeah. All right, let's continue on. We have got more comments. We have, hey, Gray. Oh, the voices are back, says Cookie Coco. Yes, the voices, I do tend to, when I'm in the mood, I like to kind of accent, which is a really cool, you know, really cool word, really appropriate word for what I'm about to say. I like using accents to spice up my game a little bit, like Impa. Oh, you know, the old lady voice. Oh, Zelda. Oh. You know, that kind of thing. I do like that. And so sometimes I'll use the voice if I'm in the mood. If I'm in the mood, I'll try. Cookie Coco says, hey, Gray. Hey. Pink Rose says, great video. Thank you, Pink Rose. Let me see. We got keywords from Holly and from Red K. Hello, everyone. Brendan McBride says, hi, Gray. I hope everyone has a great weekend. Thank you. I hope you do too as well, Brenda. Pink Rose gives me a heart. Thank you, Pink Rose. Hearts back. We've got Brenda McBride. We got saying, hi, Gray. Hello, Brenda. Brenda always says hi to me every day. I appreciate that so much. It makes my day. Thank you very much. Holly Larson says, I put in previous video, but I think the Rudolph cartoons were done with claymation. That's exactly right. Claymation is exactly right. Love those cartoons. Love them. Holly Larson says, much better. The music is muted. I can hear you now, but you sound like you're in a deep hole. Yeah, it's a studio mic. That's why. This is the microphone that I use for voiceovers. And the mic that you usually hear me on is my headset. And so it's it's an Arctis Nova 7 head, or is it 7 or 9? I don't know which one it is. I have both. But it's an Arctis, and it's a really good headset. So you hear me that on, like, the PS5. You hear me on, like, Dreamlight Valley and what else? Astrobot and stuff like that is my headset. When I come to Nintendo, I have to go through all kinds of contraptions and capture cards, and I have to use a headset, headphones, no headset, and I have to use an external studio mic. So, yeah, so it's a pain in the butt. Nintendo does not make it easy for content creators at all. They are really, really in the Stone Age when it comes to their hardware as far as content creation goes. You know, they're really, yeah. I mean, for like a company that has such beautiful games, they're really, really, yeah, they're Stone Age when it comes to content creation and recording. I mean, everyone else is miles, miles ahead of them. I mean, who wants to sit here and hook up a capture card and string wires and then get OBS or whatever else that you're using to record and then having to hook up a mic? No, thank you. I just want to hit a record button like I do on the PS5 and record what I'm playing and talk to my friends and my subscribers and my friends who are subscribers and just be done with it. I don't want to go through all this wire crap. Sorry, but that's the way it is with Nintendo. So Holly Larson says, depending on the music, I might have missed something. All right, she's talking about the very first Legend of Zelda, Echoes of Wisdom, where the music was overriding my voice. I think I've got that fixed now. But for the first video, everyone who comments on that video in the comment section, up until now, all right, after now, it won't count. Up until now, we'll get 50 points towards the contest. You'll each get, for one comment, if you comment three times, you're not getting 150 points. Each person gets one. If you've already commented, if you comment after this, you don't get it. I'm sorry, but you know, it's kind of cheating. So if you've already commented in the first Legend of Zelda Echoes of Wisdom, the one that has the bad sound, because not everyone could hear the keywords. So you won't get points for keywords in that video at all. You're gonna get straight 50 points if you've commented at least once in that in that video, but only one time. You're not going to get, you know, for every comment. All right. Let's see. We got Pink Rose says, hi, I'm watching. Thanks for addressing the audio issues. Yeah, thank you, Pink Rose. Holly Larson says, claymation, I think. Yes, it was claymation. That's exactly right. We got, what else do we have here? Brendan McBride says, some of Rankin Bass programs were Rudolph, of course, the Isle of Misfit Toys, Santa's Coming to Town, my favorite, says Brenda. I like that one, too. That one had the Winter Warlock in it, and I loved the Winter Warlock. It was voiced by Keenan Wynn, and he was fantastic in that. You remember that? He was like, put one foot in front of the other, and soon you'll be walking through the door. Is it through the door or out the door? And soon you'll be walking out the door. I think it's out the door. Yeah, the Winter Warlock. He was supposed to be mean and evil, and then he turned nice and helped Kris Kringle, become Santa Claus. Put one foot in front. Yeah, it was amazing. Keenan Wynn played the Winter Warlock. So, yeah. I loved it. I loved the voiceovers. I loved everything about those. And it was Kris Kringle was voiced by Mickey Rooney. It was Mickey Rooney in that, I believe. And I think the other one was, what was her name? Oh, I used to remember it. Shirley something. And she was Hazel on that old, like, 60s TV show. Shirley something. She played Mrs. Claus, at least in one of them. I don't know if it was that one, but I know she played at least one Mrs. Claus. Shirley, I can't think of her last name. But she played Hazel. So, yeah, she voiced Mrs. Claus. She was the one. If Santa Claus is Coming to Town, okay, that's, I think my favorite one is The Year Without a Santa Claus, where they have Heat Miser and they call me Snow Miser. Whatever I touch turns to ice in my clutch. I'm too much. That one I love. I think that's my favorite is Snow Miser and Heat Miser. I love that one. Yes, that was one of the best ones, I think, from Rankin Bass. And I know Shirley Booth, that's her name. She played Mrs. Claus in that, and Mickey Rooney played, it has a really, or he played Santa Claus in that. It has a really good scene in it too, where Santa goes to visit this kid's house in, I think it was called Southtown, where it's always sunny. And what a touching scene they have there, where he's like, I believe in Santa Claus, because it was a song. I believe in Santa Claus as I believe in love. You know, because you can't see him doesn't mean he's not real. That was the whole point, you know, just like love. You can't see love, but you know love is real, right? So that's what the whole thing with on Santa Claus was. And if, listen, hey, listen, we're going to do a keyword for this video if you're watching it. Santa Claus is going to be the keyword for this. This is just a chat video. But, yes. oh, man, I can't wait. That's why I love the holidays. I believe in Santa Claus. Yes, that's my favorite one. That has to be my favorite one. She also says, I think Frosty was also Rankin. Yes, Frosty was Rankin Bass, and so was the Easter Bunny is Coming to Town. Do you remember that one with the rabbit, the evil rabbit? What was his name? Clank Tail or something? Iron Tail? Something like that. He had like an iron tail. And it was really, really good. So, and Brenda said, that's all I remember. Frosty was great too. It had, what's his name? Was it Professor Hinkle, whatever his name was? Yeah, just amazing. So, okay. Thank you very much, Brenda. Brenda says, hi, Gray. Hello. Hi, Gray. And also says Brenda again. Hi, I love when Brenda posts. She says it every day just about, and it makes my day. Hi, Brenda. we got some comments by Red K. Cookie Coco says, I was going to see Beetlejuice for my birthday, but I kept hearing it wasn't good. It was terrible. It was. Tim Burton should be ashamed of him. You know, I love Tim Burton. I absolutely love Michael Keaton. My favorite Batman of all time. Well, I like Adam West too, but I like Michael Keaton as the movie Batman. The TV Batman will always be Adam West, but they ashamed. I mean, even like I like everything that I've seen of Michael Keaton, and this one I really didn't care for. I didn't care for him, and I'm ashamed to say it because I love him so much. Tim Burton, he should be ashamed for putting this out. Sorry, but it really was bad. It was bad. Some people will like it, and they'll, you know, probably disagree with my opinion, but I think I'm among the majority that just did not like this movie. It was terrible. Don't ruin a good thing, and that's what they did. So no thank you. I will never watch that again. Allie and I are going to see in November Red One. If you haven't seen that, if you haven't seen the trailer for that, go watch that. It's got Dwayne The Rock Johnson. It's got Chris Evans. And it looks fantastic for a Christmas movie. I can't wait to see it. It's about Santa Claus getting kidnapped. I mean, it's an old premise, but still, it looks hilarious. So please, go watch the trailer. In fact, if you want me to, No, you know what? I'm not going to advertise for them, but I guess I just did. watch the trailer. It's called Red One, and it looks so hilarious. I can't wait. So we're going to go see that. We're looking forward to it. It comes out in November. So yeah, awesome. Hey, Gray, you're not the curator. You're also the janitor, LOL. That's right. I do everything. I do it all. You know, janitors have an important job. So, yeah. Cookie Coco also says, I haven't been to my shelter in a few months, but I participated virtually in Rocky's Empty the Shelter event a few weeks ago. Let's see. I was in the running to adopt this doggy named Luke. Luke, I am your... Oh, we got to talk about that in a second, too. James Earl Jones. Luke, I am your father. I wanted him so bad, and they were transporting dogs as part of the event. But some rascal there in California waltzed in and adopted my Luke locally. So, of course, they wanted to save thousands on a transport, and that local rascal got my dog. Oh, I'm sorry, Cookie. I'm sorry. Oh, did I say happy birthday for... Yeah, you said it was your birthday. If you wanted to go see Beetlejuice, happy birthday. Happy birthday. I don't celebrate birthdays. But happy birthday to you. I think we've talked about this in previous videos. But I really hate that. I really hate that about shelters. There are some that would rather put dogs to sleep than transport them. Instead of saving their lives, I guess it would cost an arm and a leg to, but there are charities out there. There are organizations that will transport dogs, but I have lost so many dogs because they wouldn't transport and they couldn't find a transport that I've wanted to rescue, and it breaks my heart. So I understand. I'm right there with you, Cookie. I get you. And Rocky Kanaka, I love him. What a treasure he is. He's a treasure. He's right up there, you know, with all the other rescues, like Devnaz, who's doing it in Turkey. That poor guy. I feel bad for him. You know, he's just, yeah, you know what? That poor guy is, he's overburdened with dogs. And Turkey is a horrible country for their treatment of dogs. Screw you, Turkey. Screw you, China. You know what? I hate those countries. I hate them. I hate them. You know? They're horrible. But I'm right there with you about the transport thing. And there are some shelters that would rather just not even offer transport. They'll put the dog down before they transport. And it's terrible. It's terrible that a dog has to pay for its life. Speaking of that, Rocky Kanaka, I put up one of his videos today. Yesterday on my Facebook. And he went to the shelter. And there's this beautiful 7-month-old Doberman, purebred. She looks like she's purebred. She's beautiful. Her name is Daisy May. She's beautiful. In fact, we're going to do two keywords. The other one is going to be Daisy May. So we got Santa Claus is going to be one. Santa Claus is one keyword for this video. The next one is Daisy May. All right? We clear? But Daisy May is a seven-month-old Doberman, and she's so scared. She's just a pup. She's a baby. She's a little baby. And these asshats that owned her got rid of her because they're getting a divorce. Welcome to the majority, folks. Welcome to the majority. Who hasn't been through a divorce? I've been through one. So what? So you have to give up your dog because your little heart is broke? Poor you. Poor you. So your dog has to pay with its life because your little heart is in pieces because your husband, your wife, decided they didn't want to be with you anymore? Boo-hoo. You took on a responsibility 7 months ago, and now this dog could possibly pay with its life because you're an asshat, because your heart's broke and you can't take it. Oh, listen. More people in this country, I don't know the actual stats, but I'm sure it's pretty high, get divorced than stay married. I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong about that. I'm not going to quote the facts, but I know the divorce rate's pretty hot, you know, pretty high. All right. I think it's at least half of all marriages end in divorce. So you know what? Your dog shouldn't, you're the one that is the problem. Your dog did nothing. Your dog did absolutely nothing. And you decided, oh, well, my heart's breaking. That's temporary. All right? That's temporary. Killing your dog is permanent, you idiot. Permanent. That dog is scared. That dog is terrified. You had just destroyed its world because your little heart's broken. Ugh. These people just really tick me off. They make me mad. So please, if you want to see this dog, she's on my Facebook. I'm sure she's going to get adopted. She's a baby. She's 7 months old. She's a beautiful dog. I'm sure someone will get her. Hopefully. I would love to have her, but she's in, I think she's in California. But these people are asshats. Totally. I don't know if she's in, I think she is. I'm sorry, but if you split up, your dog, you should have to pay that. Maybe you should go sit in the shelter and be on the euthanasia list, you stinking idiot. You deserve to be there more than your dog does. Ugh. Just ticks me off. So there you have it. Okay, moving along. Cookie Coco says, epic Mickey art book. Yes, I have probably close to 1,000 art books. I used to be a big collector of art books. I have all kinds of art, like, you know, Leonardo da Vinci, Michelangelo, Salvador Dali. I got everything. I loved art. I was an art major in college. I went into animation and art. And then I changed it. I went into journalism, but I used to be in animation. It never left me. So every, like, all the game books I have, art books on all the Pixar movies, every game for the last probably 20 years, I have probably an art book on, up until probably 3 years ago. And, you know, I stopped collecting them because I have too many. But I do have the Epic Mickey one from when the game first came out. Like, what was it? 14 years ago? 15 years ago? Beautiful. Beautiful book. So I think I have one and two for art books. So, yeah. Because I love the Disney animation. I studied under a few ex-Disney animators when I was in college. I did some workshops with Don Bluth. And I took some workshops with Aaron Blaze. If you don't know who Don is, he did like Robin Hood, and he went on to his own studio where he did a lot of his own movies, All Dogs Go to Heaven, which is kind of appropriate. He also did The Secret of Nim and the 5-0 movies on American Tale. So, yeah, so I started to eat under him. And then also Aaron Blaise, who did The Lion King and Brother Bear, a few others. The only one that I wasn't able to get classes with was Glenn Keane, who's my one of my absolute favorites. Glenn Keane, of course, you know, he did a lot of the more modern Disney stuff. But absolutely love him. He did Tarzan, which is my absolute favorite movie, my absolute favorite Disney movie, as far as current movies. And I have the art book for that too, and I love it. It's my prize. The only one I have two prize art books, two prize possessions. I have the Tarzan art book, and I have the one of the original Bambi art books. It's called the Bambi sketchbook from the nine old men. It's what they were called. The like original nine Disney animators, Milt Call and a few others like John, you know, a few other ones that you know, were the like original nine animators of Disney artists. And I have that book, the Bambi book. That's probably my prize possession right there. I love it. And I love it. I just love it. anyway, that is that. I haven't looked back at Dreamlight Valley since I've been playing Astrobot and Epic Mickey, says Cookie Coco. I don't blame you. I haven't been on either. I have to get on before the Star Path ends, and probably I'll have to buy the Star Path the rest of it. So just to you know, get caught up. Cookie Coco also says, I have played Epic Mickey until my eyes crossed. Oh, that's awesome. I love the game. Love it. Love it. Love it. Love it. I wish I could play it all in one sitting, but, you know, if you want to do videos, you can't. You know, it would be like a 20-hour video, so I have to do it in pieces, unfortunately. But that's the way it goes. All right. Hi, Grace. It's Brenda. Hello. Pink Girl says, I think you have 5 days to finish the Star Path. Hopefully you can finish it. Oh, yeah, I'll buy it. Just to get it done. Holly Larson says the same thing. Star Path ends in 6 days. Hurry, Gray. I will. I'll get it done. So what's the next one? I'll have to look it up, what the next Star Path is. And Brenda McBride, our last comment of the morning is, good morning, Gray and everyone. Good morning, Brenda. Good morning, everyone. Good morning to you all. This is a comment video. This isn't a gameplay video, so we're just doing comments. Now, talking about earlier, we're talking about James Earl Jones. Luke, I am your father. He passed away. What a great man. His voice was amazing. Darth Vader, Mufasa. Woo! And yeah, lost him. Lost him. We're losing all of our treasures. Who did we just lose? We lost, oh man. We just lost, what's her name? Maggie, what's her last name? I can't think of her last name. Maggie, oh, come on, Gray. You know what it is. Maggie Smith. Maggie Smith. Just lost Maggie Smith. You know, my mind just went blank for a second. And I know everyone's going to say, oh, you know, Maggie Smith, yuck, she's Harry Potter. Oh, no. You know what? Listen. If that's all you know her from, then you don't know Maggie Smith movies. Maggie Smith was in the prime of Miss Jean Brody back in the 60s, and I think she won an Oscar for that. I think she won an Oscar for that movie. She was also in Downton Abbey. If you haven't watched, you know, listen, Harry Potter, I don't care what you got to say. She was amazing in Harry Potter as Professor McGonagall. And a lot of the newer, like, you know, the millennials, that's the only thing that they know her for is, Harry Potter. So, and they're like, I don't like Harry Potter. I don't like Harry Potter. I don't care about Maggie Smith. I don't like Harry Potter. I don't care. She's not defined by, well, unfortunately she kind of is with the millennials, but she's not defined by, you know, by Harry Potter. I mean, she's probably, yeah, she's well known for it. But she won an Oscar for the prime of Miss Jean Brody. And she was great. She was great in Downton Abbey. Yeah, as the Dowager. Just an amazing woman. Her son is a good actor too. His name is Toby. Is it Toby? Toby something. But he played in Black Sails. If you ever watched that show, Toby. Come on, which use your brain, Dave. Or, I mean, Gray. I just said my. Oh, well, you all know my real name anyway. Toby Stevens is his name, I believe. And he was in Black Sails. He played the captain. You know, like the main character. I forgot his name. I don't remember his name in it because I haven't seen it in years. But it was such a great. If you like pirates, that's the one to watch. It's a little bit. It's a little bit. Adult. Yeah, you don't want to watch it with your kids if you have young kids, and you don't want to watch it with your adult kids either because it's got a lot of you know what in it, a lot of coupling. I'll say in a really good way. Yeah. So it was, but it was. It's a good show if you like pirates and that kind of deal. Wasn't Maggie Smith in the movie like Sister Act 2 from what I remember? Was she in that? Was she like one of the nuns in that? I don't remember, but she was in quite a few movies that are not Harry Potter. She was in, I think, Death in the Nile, on the Nile. She was in. Did she, I don't remember. I think she had a few other ones, Virginia or something, and a couple other things that she's known for. But I watched her in a few of her recent, and I watched the Prime of Miss Jean Brody a long time ago. Sorry, I had to cough. But yeah, that she was a great actress. She wasn't just known for Harry Potter. So there you have it. So we're losing them. It's so hard to see people age. How do you feel about aging? I mean, do you think it's like a friend that we travel with on a great lifetime adventure? As we age, we have new adventures. Or do you see it as this cloud over you that always want? I don't like aging. I don't like the thought of it. I don't like to think about mortality. And I've come, you know, quite face to face with it a few times. So, you know, it's scary. It's scary because life is so short. You don't realize it, but life is very short. When you see these people who have kind of been in your life your whole life, James Earl Jones, you know, I mean, I've always known him as like a Darth Vader's voice since the beginning. That's what I'm saying. And now he's gone, you know, Lion King, Darth Vader. And he was in other things. Wasn't he in Roots from what I recall? I don't remember. Maybe he wasn't. But an amazing personality. And, you know, from what I understand, I don't know him, but he was an amazing person. So it's sad. It's sad that it all has to end that way, doesn't it? But how do you guys feel about that? Put it in the comments how you feel about aging and, and getting older and retiring and that kind of thing. So I don't like it. I just don't. Anyway, we're going to cut it short now. Or not short. I mean, how long have we been going? Let me look at the time here. I've been reading comments away. We've been on here for about 30 minutes. Yeah, half an hour. That's pretty good. All right, so we're going to call it here. That's all the comments anyway we have. I hope you all have a wonderful day. We're going to play some Zelda in the next video. So please tune in, put down the keywords, and let's play some games. Get out there and have some fun this weekend. Make sure you please take a half hour. You just spent a half hour listening to me ramble on. Take a half hour, even if you don't listen to me, if you skip my video or whatever this weekend, take that half hour and go visit your local animal shelter, okay? Go visit your local animal shelter. Take that half hour. If you're worried about missing keywords and you tell me that you went to your local animal shelter, put it in a in one video, and I'll give you points for it. All right. So just once to say that I went. Don't cheat. Don't lie. Be honest. Be a good human being. If you went to your local animal shelter, however many points are in the video, I'll give you for that one video. No, wait a minute. We can't do that because that's not going to work, because then it's going to be in every video. all right, let's skip that. All right. If you go and visit your local animal shelter, if you go and visit your local animal shelter this weekend, I'll give you points in this video. I'll give you an, how am I going to work that? I don't want to make it so it's just, all right. Yeah. If you go and visit your local animal shelter, that's not going to work. It's not going to work, is it? I can't think of a way to do it so that it would work. So, just let me know if you go and visit your local animal shelter, and I will, I can't. I just don't know how I would work it without screwing up the work. So I guess I'll just, please go visit your local animal shelter. Even if you have to skip one of my videos or whatnot, I mean, just do it because you're a good human being. I can't, off the top of my head, I mean, if I put some thought to it, I might be able to work something out. But right now, I just can't think of how I would do that and be able to only limit it to one video, because then I'll have to be putting it in every video, and that's a lot of work. So it would be way too random. I'll figure something out, but please, if you have time, take a half hour, go visit your local animal shelter. Even if you don't have a half hour, take 10 minutes when you're gone grocery shopping, you know, to pick up your groceries. Get a half dozen cans of dog food, half dozen cans of cat food, and drop it off on your way home to your animal shelter, please. Or, you know, just a bag of dog food, drop it off at your local animal shelter. All right. And I'll figure something out, like on Facebook, you know, if you post your receipt for like a dog food or cat food on your, on my Facebook, you know, like a picture or something, or you like send me a picture of a receipt of your dog food. I don't know. I'll figure something out, but let's talk about that at a later date. I had to think about it now. I just had like a brainstorm, but then it kind of, you know, it dissipated. So let's leave it at right now. Just please go visit your animal shelter or drop off food or something. Please. I beg of you, as a friend, I ask you to help out your local shelter. All right. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you guys in the gaming video coming up next.